Hello everyone, welcome to the Port Calls YouTube channel. Today our consultant, Mr. Dexter Pedresa, discusses CMO 03-2022 on the revised rules on establishment, supervision, operation, and control of your customs bonded warehouses. Here he is.
So now we come to your customs memorandum order 3-2022. Now which basically operationalizes your CAO 1-2022. So CMO 2022 implements an IT-enabled CBW management system and details accountabilities of BOC personnel assigned to CBW and CBW operators, including client exporters. So under CMO 3-2022, goods for transfer to CBWs are subject to mandatory non-intrusive inspection at the port of discharge. No? Whether covered by goods declaration for warehousing or goods declaration for transit. So difference doon sa mga not familiar, yung warehousing, ito yung pina-file nyo na entry kapag dumating yung goods nyo. Kunyari, yung warehouse nyo nandito sa Manila, discharge sa Port of Manila or sa warehousing entry na yung ipa-file nyo. Kasi yung warehouse is nasa Manila na rin. Pero for example, yung warehouse nyo is nasa Batangas. So, may jurisdiction doon is the Port of Batangas. So, dumating dito sa Manila, hindi warehousing entry ang ipa-file nyo, but what? Transit SAD, yung single administrative document na for transit. So, syempre, kasi kailangan i-transit muna siya from Manila to Batangas. Pagdating sa Batangas, saka pa-filean ng warehousing. Talking about transit, anong pinagkaiba ng transit sa transshipment? Ang transit is local movement. Transshipment is international. Hindi lalabas, hindi kailangan lumabas ng port, no? Yung transshipment. Alright. Okay, unless goods entered for warehousing are under alert order or selected for physical or non-intrusive examination, the district collector should allow, no, the immediate transfer of bonded goods to the CBWs where 100% physical examination will be conducted. So CMO 3-2022 provides the importation to CBW should be made within the limits of the warehouse's authority or license as applied for and approved. In other words, the CBW operator cannot just import anything at will, no? So if those imports are not allowed under the warehouse license, pwede siyang masabing technical smuggling. Goods not authorized for importation under warehousing or in excess of the volume and quantity allowed under the CBW's license will be subject to payment of duties and taxes. Ang dami pong mga CBW, hundreds of millions dahil dito. Ano po ito? Ito ang inyong summary of monthly raw material importation requirement. So ito po yung document na nililista nyo, nanggagaling naman po sa CBW yan. No? So nandito nakalista kung ano yung ini-import nyo. What type, HS code, ano yung volume on a monthly basis, which is being approved by the district collector through the CBW committee. No? So, kailangan ma-approve ni Customs yun. Ingat po kayo. Minsan, hindi natatatakan yung SMRIR. Okay? So, kailangan po yun is may tatak ni BOC for it to be official. Okay. Kasi kung hindi, ang laking penalty. Hindi lang ho basta duties and taxes. Okay? So pag na ano kayo ni PICAG, may interest pa ho yan, which is 20% per annum. Ang bigat po nun. Yun ang nagpapalobo sa binabayaran sa BOC, not the principal. Minsan ang principal, what, mga nasa siguro mga 20% lang. The rest of the amount is your penalties. Kasi pinakamababa mong penalty sa PICAG is 125% plus 20% per annum. Diba? Eh kung 3 years yung in-audit sa inyo, marami pong iiyak. Yun, yung isa pang na-mention ko kanina, yung sa list of importables. Kailangan din po, makikita nyo yun sa inyong authority to operate. So authority to operate, mahaba pong dokumento yon. Meron doon listahan ng mga raw materials that you are or the CBW operator is allowed to import. Pag wala na naman doon, yari na naman po. So you have to be very vigilant, no? Doon sa mga kliyente nyo or kayo mismo, CBW, you really have to properly advise them. Okay, to continue. So, except when goods are intended for use, no, as a component in the manufacture or production of another finished products for export, as approved by the Customs Bonded Warehouse Committee, the CBW operator cannot import finished goods for warehousing. So, hindi po pwede. So, restricted and regulated goods without the corresponding clearance and or import authority issued by a competent authority may be seized and forfeited. So, again, although warehousing yan, although you don't pay duties and taxes, pero it's not exempt for regulations of other trade regulating government agencies. Okay, no withdrawals for domestic consumption will be allowed, no, except upon approval by the district collector as recommended by the operating division and only upon payment of the corresponding duties and taxes. Such withdrawal for local sales, no, domestic or domestic sales should not exceed, no, as earlier again mentioned, 30% to the total volume of the bonded raw materials transferred to the CBW for the year. Take note, no, the prohibition on the threshold limit for local sales does not apply to yung private customs bonded warehouses. Before, wala kayong makikitang strict provisions. So, dun sa mga brokers dito or those who are practicing in customs, ako ho, wala akong nakita na batas. Meron lang parang a memo from, I forgot na kung sinong commissioner, mentioning about that 30%. But there is no explicit regulation like this one. Eh ngayon talagang, di ba? Kasi doon sa may mga klienteng CBW sa inyo or may mga CBW, madalas eh, lagpas 30%. No? So, eto, may legal basis. Next, no, a manufacturing customs bonded warehouse operator or accredited member may, on account of insufficiency of operational facilities or a lack of material time to meet export commitment, withdraw the bonded goods without payment of duties and taxes and subcontract its processing. Of course, no, subject to approval of the district collector and certain guidelines under CMOC-2022. Not allowed under CAU-3-2022, no, yung importation by your industry-specific customs-bonded warehouses of fibers, yards, fabrics, and accessories for the manufacture of garments. So, specific, ano nga siya. So, ICBW, hindi pwede. If yun ang category mo. Alright, and finally, so the Customs Commissioner may order the audit, sinasabi ko kanina, and inspection of the CBWs by the Warehousing, Monitoring, and Audit Unit of the Post-Clearance and Audit Group based on certain grounds including derogatory report information as a prerequisite to renewal to. Yan, so medyo let's be mindful, no? Meron ng very detailed tong cow and CMO that the customs released on CBW operations. So kailangan maingat po tayo, especially in advising our clients. And don't care if somebody is from a CBW here, sa operations nyo. Because mag-snowball po yan kapag hindi nyo naayos. 2 millions and millions of pesos of penalties.